So this Seagate DJI FlyDrive enables me to work anywhere I want. It's a 2 terabyte USB-C hard drive, which is compatible with all the latest hardware. It's also backwards compatible with earlier MacBook Pros with USB 3 ports. But what makes it so special is that it has a built-in UHS 2 micro SD card reader. So you can just take your micro SD card straight out of your drone, pop it into the drive, and that eliminates the need to have extra card readers and extra cables and things like that. So all you need really is your laptop and one drive. The other great thing about working with this drive is that I can start working here in Premiere Pro, and then if I want, I can take this drive, plug it into another computer, and continue working on the Premiere Pro project because all the files live inside of this drive. And if you don't have Adobe Premiere Pro, when you get the FlyDrive, it actually comes bundled with 2 months free of Adobe Premiere Pro, so make sure you take advantage of that. So here I am on location. I've been flying for my DJI Mavic Pro, and I want to see what I've shot. So what I can do is I put this card directly into the FlyDrive, jump onto my laptop here, and I can have a look at some of the photos and videos that I've shot. I can even do some quick edits here in Premiere Pro and right here on location, and maybe, you know, just upload them to social media, or I can take it away and work on it later on another computer. So now we're going to launch Premiere Pro. And here we are inside of Premiere Pro. And this is part one of a 3-part series to help you get started with Premiere with your drone footage. In this lesson, we're going to do 3 things. We're going to combine clips, we're going to do color correction, and then we're going to export your video so you can share it with the world. And the first thing I'm going to do is go to the project panel here, double click, and we're going to go to the FlyDrive, and let's find the clips. And they're all right here, so I'm going to select the folder that I just imported, and then click import. Now what it's going to do is it's going to add them to the bin here, where we can now play around with them and add them to our project. Okay, and here's our clips that we just imported. So what we're going to do is we're going to trim a couple of these clips, and then we're just going to arrange them on a sequence. I'm going to add a little bit of a color grade on there, and then I'll show you how to export them. So why don't we start by double clicking here, and what it does is it opens it up here inside the left window. And this left window is where we can examine our clip. So we can go through here, and I can set the in and out points if I want. So what I need to do is just tap the I key, and that will set the end point. So what that does is it just trims it to the section that I want to begin playing at. And then I want to go to about there, and I'm going to hit the O key. And what that's done now is it's taken this longer clip, a 35 second clip, and it's just trimmed it into just a few seconds there. So we just simply take it and we drag it here. Notice that nothing has been created yet, but as soon as we release it, what it does is it grabs all the settings from that clip there, which is a 4K clip actually, and creates a new project. Now, if we want to add a second clip, let's double click on this clip. Let's view it. And, you know, if we want to maybe start from here, we can just hit the I key for the endpoint, move it back to there, hit the O for the out point. And now we can simply click and drag it to add it to our sequence there. All right, so we can make some adjustments here. Notice it's showing white, which means it's selected. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go up here. The first thing we can do is choose our white balance by grabbing this little eyedropper, and we go for an area of white, click on it, and that will actually set the white balance overall. Then we can get our exposure, which is our brightness. Let's brighten that up a little bit. Notice when we do that, we're losing a little bit of our highlights there, so we can take our highlights, we can push those back to recover them. We can open up our shadows a little bit, but notice if you go too far, it starts to look a little faded. So let's bring it back a little bit. And now we're just gonna give the whites just a little bit of a boost. There we go, just to bring them back nice and clean so they're not milky. And then we're gonna push in our blacks to give it a little bit of body and depth. There we go. And then we could just give it a little punch of contrast if we wanted, just to give it a little bit more. All right, so if you want to see what this looks like before and after, we go under the effect control, and we'll see there's a Lumetri color, turn it off, that's before, and that's after. So you could go ahead and you could apply different adjustments to each one of those clips. And then when you're finished and you're ready to export it, what you're going to do is you're going to go up under here and you're going to choose to export media. Here's our export media, so you're going to choose your location of where you want to put it to. And then you can go under here and just choose a preset. So I'm just going to go down all the way down in here. And if you wanted to go to YouTube, you know, we could output it at YouTube 4K, which would be here. Or we could drop it down to 1080. It would be entirely up to you. In this case, because we've shot this clip in 4K, we could put it out as a 4K clip. So now that I'm done with this video, I'm gonna upload it to YouTube and then also to DJI SkyPixel, which is a great community of drone users. And look me up there, you'll find me at Colin Smith. So thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you next time.